So if you're a regular on this channel, you'll know that I like to feature lots of UCL grads, asking them lots of questions around the work they do, how they figured out how to get there. This episode is similar, but a little bit different in the question that I'm posing. I first spoke to Jasmin about what career advice she might give herself if she could go back in time and have a conversation with her younger self.
Ooh, I kind of have two, Raj. I would tell my younger self to really think about what would make me happy long term, because you spend most of your life at work. So I would really think about the type of person you are and the environment that you'll thrive in and enjoy, rather than chasing the money or something that you'd expect to go into. Another career advice I'd give myself, my younger self, would be to not get knocked back with rejection. I remember back to my earlier days when I was just starting my working life straight after university, and I really wanted to work abroad. And the opportunity to work abroad would have been my dream come true. And in order to get that, you have to keep trying. So in order to do that, I got knocked back numerous times, because obviously I didn't have enough work experience, and to work abroad is a pretty hard thing to achieve. So I got in contact with a lot of people on LinkedIn. I got in contact with I got a lot of rejections as well. But because I was so eager to move abroad, I just kept going with it, kept contacting businesses that I'd be interested in, and companies and people, and it worked out in the end.
So Jasmin landed a role in an internet startup in Mexico after graduating. And I really like how she completely depersonalizes rejection, instead using it as a kind of data point to figure out what she needed to do to get to where she wanted to get to. I next spoke to Marion, a UCL graduate and author of publications such as Should I Do a PhD and A Mindful PhD. Marion currently works at Wowcher as a senior data analyst. And here's what she shared when I asked her what advice she'd give her younger self.
Life works in very strange ways. And you'll find that your career path may not be sort of linear. I feel like, in hindsight now, I don't think that you necessarily need to know the exact career path, but I feel like as if what you do want to know is what is most important to you. What are some of your values? What are some of the things that you do want in life? So if family life is very important to you, you want to have do you want a big house? You want a small house? Whereabouts do you kind of want to end up? And then start thinking about what kind of salary would I require to be able to get there? And so you don't necessarily know the career itself, but you know sort of the outline of what you want life to look like for you. And you know, honestly, we do all spend our time thinking, okay, by the age of 30, I want to have a house, two kids, my car, and all that kind of thing. And it doesn't always happen. And in fact, a lot of the time it doesn't happen. But it is still important to just have a vision of what it is that you are looking for, and then being able to sort of say, okay, this is what's going to best get me to where I want to be. Along the way, obviously, utilize the people around you. It's so important to have good friends that are also trying to sort of know what's important to them, how they're going to make it in to their goals as well. And you guys can bounce off each other, finding mentors and people around you, teachers, family members, people who've gone down these paths before you. Finally, I just think it's very important to look after your mental health. Looking after not only your mental health, obviously your physical health as well. And so even amongst all of these decisions that you're trying to make in life, just know that that is number one priority. There's no point in trying to force yourself into this top amazing career if you're losing your mind at the same time. So please genuinely make sure you look after your mental health.
A lovely point, beautifully made by Marion, and I'd certainly echo it. Mental and physical well-being should never be an afterthought when thinking about a career, a future, and even a present. I also really love what Marion says about focusing on what's most important to you and then kind of populating an image around that. As with other things, career paths can look so obvious looking back, but never obvious looking forward. I next put this question to Mohamed.
I wasn't the most career-driven when I started university. I think I've barely done anything in my first year, like in terms of like society-wise and so on. Like I was very focused on making as many friends as I possibly can in my UCL accommodation, that it literally kind of drove me away from what I should be doing at this point, which is not something that I do regret, by the way. But at the same time, it's something that would have saved me a lot of time and a lot of effort by the time I was actually doing my applications. And I guess at that point, there were so many of my friends doing a lot of society work and they're applying for first year reps in societies. For instance, they're getting to attend a lot of the different presentations that different societies are actually putting out there, getting to understand what they would be interested in. But I guess I kind of missed out on all of these stuff at the beginning just because I wasn't really thinking about that much. And in turn, I think this made me miss out on a lot of spring insight weeks as well, which is something that I've always heard would make it different if you make the cut. So like if you're able to make the cut through a spring and then you actually turn that into a summer internship where you turn that into a grad scheme, it does save you a lot of time. Forget about all the applications that we're doing all these years and suddenly you just enjoy your final years of university. It would definitely make a difference. But at that point, I wasn't really aware of that and I wasn't really interested in that, I'd say, which did make a difference that the final years became more stressful and they became harder. It doesn't necessarily mean that it's pretty late because it's really not late anyway. You get people getting offers at different points, whether it's like at the beginning with the spring insight or even summer, and then they turn it to grad or just a grad straight away, or even sometimes they graduate, they get this gap year and then they get a job offer after a year. So like it really doesn't define you at what point of this journey you actually join the firm. I was really unsure of whether I wanted to do engineering or wanted to do consulting or wanted to do investment banking, or like there was a lot going on and there's always this hype around university. You get those, let's say, squad of consulting and like this is the investment banking squad and this is the engineering squad, and like there's always this hype around different things and you're just standing there going like, okay, what am I doing? And I guess if you don't really inform this, you're just going to be pretty, let's say, lost for a while and until you try through like internships and so on. But there's always an easier route to do it. So like if you actually attend a lot of like the different presentations that are being done, if you join certain clubs or societies that they do consulting projects or engineering projects or whatever, you get a better taste to what exactly you would want to do, and this would definitely make it easier for you when you're applying.
There's loads to unpack here, and I really love this real talk from Mohamed. Firstly, about timings, it really is never too early or too late to think about a career or a career plan. It's a paradox, but it really is true. And I also love how Mohamed talks about different tribes of people, that group for law, that group for marketing, and how hearing talks and talking about what people are excited about in respect of their tribes is a really good way of figuring out whether you might be excited by the same things. Seriously great stuff there from Mohamed, Marion and Jasmin. Thank you so much. Now, coming up, I have a Q&A episode coming out, and if you'd like your careers questions, any careers question, to feature in that video, please email me at careers.marketing@ucl.ac.uk. I absolutely love receiving those. And that's it from me for this week. I'll see you next time.